Welcome to Turf Wars Kickball, powered by Manscaped. It's part of ESPN 8, the Ocho Day, presented by Sonic. And this day rolls on. We have got, in a lot of ways, the main event. We've got our kickball showdown coming your way from Manchester Meadows Park in Rock Mill, South Carolina. Glad that you are with us. We have got two teams left standing in this Turf Wars Battle of the States. We have had teams from up and down the East Coast and all around the nation competing. The tournament has two teams left standing. So we got our representatives from Florida. That's FOE.
And then right outside everything.
Our nation's capital, DMZ Dream Team, with my partner in crime, and Dwayne Lucas, Kevin Fitzgerald with you. All right, Dwayne, listen, we've got two quality teams. We've got two rosters of talented kickballers here. What should the viewers at home expect today in this kickball battle today?
They should expect some high-quality athleticism and strategy. These are two great defensive and offensive teams, so you're going to get a great, great game of kickball today.
Some of the rules that stand out here, you look at the top one, three strikes, three balls per at bat. You got to have at least eight fielders on the field at all times. What else should fans be aware of today?
Along with the eight fielders, but you're definitely going to get 10. It's going to be six males and four females on the field. The kicking lineup, you must kick at least 13 players. And as you see, you can throw the ball at the runner. However, if the ball hits the runner and keeps going, then the play is still active and the runners keep moving if they're on base.
It could be a painful out, it sounds like, around the base pass.
Exactly, on both sides.
Let's take a look at FOE. Like you said, Florida over everyone. This is their lineup. Camp White, Lucas, Winkle, Frenchick, Anthony Frenchick, a.k.a. what's his nickname?
Legatron.
Okay, we're happy to have Legatron back in the field today. Captain Butler, Wright Miller, Kale Colbert, and then Levin and Stowe. So, GP, this event, in a lot of ways, it's turned into really one of the more popular events of this day, year in and year out. A little different format this year. So we had teams from different states, from different regions, all up and down the coast, battle it out yesterday and today. We've got two teams standing now.
Absolutely. We had teams come all the way from Arizona, Kansas City, all the way from Portland. We also had a Houston team that came out that ended up missing their flight yesterday, and they had to catch another flight and then to Atlanta and then get on the bus and drive up here just to make it here by 9:30 in the morning.
So,
but those are the sacrifices we make for this game of kickball.
So you got two teams left standing. We've got our one squad from Florida, the other from the DMV area. And so it looks like we are ready to go. Great turnout, as it always is in the stands here, for our annual kickball event. Partner, it's good to be back with you, my friend.
As always.
Let's do this one more time. And so already you can see at first glance there, our pitcher in the circle. I mean, he's going to bring some heat. What do you got on the scouting report on our pitcher today?
Oh, the scouting report, his name is Aaron King. We call him A-Case. And he pitches with power, finesse, and precision, because he can hit both sides of the plate with the cutter going to the left and to the right.
I mean, the viewers are going to get a great look from this angle, just how difficult it is. Don't just think this kickball is going to be, you know, rolled in there nice and easy for you to just bash. So King coming home again. There's also some bounces he got to deal with. Nice play by our third baseman. And so an easy out here.
Great stretch by the first baseman, Kenny Miner. Good job.
The name of the game, in a lot of ways, it's speed.
Oh, wait a minute. What happened? It must have been an encroachment call because they called him back to kick again.
Wow. So we've got an encroachment call. Is the play going to be made anyway? Our kicker is going to head back here to the plate. So what do you mean there when you say encroachment?
Well, encroachment is there's a line going across from first and third diagonally across. If one of those defensive players cross that line before the ball is kicked, it's called encroachment.
Yeah,
it ended up being a ball.
Yep, that's that dotted line in the middle of the screen.
And whatever they say the ball doesn't lie. The ball don't lie. So we went back up and did it again.
Yeah, that was Jennings who pounced on that.
looks like Kemp thinks he was close.
Oh, bang, bang play at first base. And so our umpires are going to get together here to make sure they got the proper call. So we've had a rather lengthy first at-bat, and it does look like Justin Kemp, the leadoff man, he is retired.
Yeah, on a better angle.
That's close.
I don't think it gets any closer than that.
Yeah, that's pretty much simultaneous, but nevertheless, Kemp is retired here, and so you got Lathaddeus White.
A.K.A. Blizzo.
Blizzo. With a nickname like that, I mean, you've got some game.
Absolutely. And he might be the first person. This is his third time here on the Ocho. He came the first year as a player, the second year as a coach, and he's back here the third year as a player again.
Are you telling me Blizzo has come out of retirement? He has come out of retirement here. You know, and there's a lot of pressure on a player whose nickname is Blizzo. When you have the nickname Blizzo bestowed upon you, you've got to have some talent.
Definitely. He has some wheels. He's a great bunter and a kicker, but he definitely has some wheels.
But that is one thing. Let's make clear to the audience. You just mentioned something here about bunting and bunters. It's a double kick.
Double kick.
Yep. So he's going to come back to the plate. Again, that's where the speed comes into play. It's not really all just about let's see how far you can kick it, right? You want even base runners in this game.
Absolutely. Definitely have to have base runners, and it's all about the ball speed of the bunt.
Rizzo trying to beat out the throw, and he does.
I told you, he has wheels.
Listen, when you come out of retirement and then reach base in your first at bat, that's impressive.
And we have to kick Lucas. She's a great bunter as well.
You know, Dwayne, I cannot let any more time go here. We must alert everyone. We are, you know, Sonic is our title sponsor. We are going to slush the winner. There's going to be the entire winning team will be slushed.
And that has to be a first.
Is this going to be the first nationally televised slushing? You know, I think I have a basic understanding as to what that may be, but I just want to find out to make sure later that I do know what a slushing in fact is. So the winning team will, of course, we'll have that afterwards. So like you said, Courtney Lucas is on here with one away. This is Jennings who retires Lucas. And then you got a throw and they peg him.
Got him out of here.
Accurate on-target bullseye. And they retire White. It's a double play. Check this out. Remember, all you have to do is you don't have to necessarily tag a runner or tag the base. You can peg them on the base pass.
You definitely can.
I mean, that is a heck of a throw by our first baseman. All right, so
He's also a D1 baseball player, so that was and he's left-handed, so that puts him in the right place to make that throw.
You know, it's a great point you bring up. We have got many former athletes, college athletes on display. You just saw the DMV Dream Team lineup. Russell, Lindsay, and King. We get things started here in the bottom half of the first inning. We had a scoreless top half. And there's David Russell, who lets that one go. So, who's the pitcher that we have here in the circle for FOE? So, what's the scatter report you have on the pitcher?
Well, as far as he goes, he's definitely a great pitcher as well. He pitches with a lot of cutter and a lot of speed. So, and there is the ball speed. Great by speed, and more speed. And again, with the bunt, it's just all about the ball speed of the bunt. You don't want it to, you want to go just far enough outside of the back catcher's hands and far enough from the Chargers are coming down from third base.
Because that's the key aspect. You've got that dotted line. Looks like that one might have been fielded in foul ground. So Deontay Lindsey Dot.
That's Dot. Yep. He's back again.
This was our Turf Wars Kickball MVP.
Right,
2 years ago.
Yeah, absolutely.
That one was a little inside. You can see as a kicker, you've got to deal with it. You know, a whole lot of bounce. You mentioned the cut.
It's a lot going on there when you're at the plate, so you just got to focus it and dial it in and place the ball in play. And as you see, it's coming with a lot of speed.
And we got a runner on here for DMV Dream Team.
So at this point, he just wants to put it in play.
It's a pretty good spot, and he beats out the throw. Yeah, he did just that, and put it in a very difficult spot for the fielders. Big play. Yep. So again, speed is the name of the game. You need to get base runners on. We've got some heavy hitters. Let's not forget, we do have some heavy hitters in both of these lineups.
And at the plate now, we have Kaya King, and she was one of the players that was on ESPN the first year.
So she was at this tournament now. It's now a two-time participant in this game. They get the lead out.
They get the lead out. Yep. What she wanted to do was place the ball around them and move the runners from second to third. And she just put it too far towards the middle, and they ended up getting the lead runner out.
Yeah,
but
so
up the kick down, we have our guy, Kenny Miner. That's the one that kicked the home run last year, the first home run on the Ocho. And let's see what he does. As you see, the people in the outfield, they remember, they seen the tape, and they backed up to the home run wall. They know exactly what to do because they know what they get.
The outfield, we have four outfielders back there now. So if that doesn't display what Miner could do here, let's
also
recognize.
I can guarantee you this, he's not going to get any layups.
Might be getting a whole lot of junk here from Rail. And so that is in for a strike. Again, it's just got to catch a portion of the plate. If you're a kicker here, you can wait to find the perfect offering. We got a home run fence for him to try to aim for.
Oh, there it goes.
Play was nearly made. They're going to get him at first base. They got to throw to the plate.
There it is.
And Lindsey scores the game's first run.
In sloppy fashion like he normally does. And they called Kenny safe at first. There was a play that was made, but they said that the first baseman bobbled the catch, so they called him safe.
Wow, looked like the throw might have beat him, but instead. Big swing there from Aaron King. So it is the DMV Dream Team that's got the early lead here.
And he's the kicker, too.
Bouncing ball, that's
just enough to score the run, though.
Yep, play made at first. And so it's a pair of first inning runs here for DMV Dream Team.
We got Tay Jennings up the kick, and he's probably going to try to land something to score this Kenny Miner on third.
Boy, it's a great look right there at the spin and the break.
You saw that, right?
Yep, that a pitcher can put on these throws. So, good luck. Can't be too much bounce, right? It's going to be a difficult play. We got a 3-0 lead now for Dream Team. So they have struck in the bottom half of this first inning for a 3-spot. As Miner comes home to score.
Number kick, we have Trinity Bell. Trinity Bell, she's been playing this game of kickball ever since she's been at least 6 or 7 years old. She used to come to our practices, and it's great to see the maturity and how she's grown in this sport, and now you see him playing on ESPN.
I mean, it's really neat. What is that, the kickball community like? I mean, it's family, it's competitive.
It's definitely a family atmosphere. And, you know, when we're out there playing this adult kickball, we have our kids out there, so they're out there at practices with us all the time.
Yep.
So it's only right that they learn how to play the game as well. And she's a kicker. She can put her foot on the ball, it can go too.
There's a foul ball there, so she is out. But DMV Dream Team with three runs in the opening inning. Three zip after one in Rock Hill.
Kickball on the Ocho is presented by the new Sonic $1.99 menu. Five Sonic favorites for just $1.99 each. Live free, eat Sonic. And in part by the Lawnmower 5.0 Ultra from Manscaped. See now at manscaped.com today. Back here in Rock Hill, South Carolina, our kickball main event. Turf Wars always brings a party. You know that. We've got another great crowd here. Start of the second inning. And it was a three spot. GP in the bottom of the first inning there for DMV Dream Team. So we've got the fans are here. We've got ESPN 8, the Ocho Thundersticks.
The Thundersticks.
Where's our? I need Thundersticks up here.
We definitely need some glasses and some Thundersticks
up here.
Yeah,
we'll take any merch. That is a hard rip, by the way, on the right leg of Glenn Van Winkle. So he is, you know, the cleanup man in this FOE order. Hey, so the Dream Team, by the way, we've seen them put the ball into play. How about the double play, the defense double turn to close defense, out the top half of the first inning? We had our first pegged runner on the base paths. Again, you can peg a base runner in order to retire them.
And up the kick, we have our guy, Legatron. He's coming back this year looking lean and mean.
This is Anthony Frenchick, who did not skip leg day. Let's just put it that way, right?
At all. And he's a lefty kicker, and there's no button in his game. It's going to be all pop. And he's a lefty, so right field is usually where he's aiming at.
We've got the home run fence here for the first year for the Ocho Day. This is a big deal. Oh, they get it to pop it up. So it's a nice roll there from King. That's got to feel good if you're the pitcher.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And again, it's all about the cutter on the pitch.
And that
if you don't catch a flush, it's going to roll up off your foot and pop up in the air.
I mean,
that's exactly what that did.
Yep. And these are such experienced kickers, so yeah, they're very familiar with any type of pitch, any sort of spin. But again, sometimes it's just so predictable, the bounces. Unpredictable, I should say. This is Hunter Kempton. Trying to get something going here for FOE.
Man, it's two outs. That was a quick two outs as well.
Yep. So Aaron King, he has faced the minimum to this point. King, you mentioned he's a dual threat, great pitcher, but he also can kick as well.
He's one of those all-around kickball players who pretty much do everything great.
And so this speaks to a larger point that we've talked about over the years here. You've got many, if not most of the players on the field today that were able to play their way to this championship. A lot of them are former college athletes. Whether it's track and field, baseball, I mean, this kickball circuit, this is a way for them to continue competing.
Absolutely, absolutely.
FOE, the team from Florida. We've got Dream Team representing the DMV. This tournament, GP, you said it, what, we started with 18 teams earlier today. We have whittled the field down to two left standing for this championship tilt.
Two left standing.
And that's not all, by the way. This kickball extravaganza this weekend continues here in Charlotte.
Yes, it does. It starts all back up again tomorrow and Sunday.
Yep, it's really neat to watch these players
travel. So he's
going
to have to put this one in play, or else it's going to be.
Jennings.
Oh, she came off the barrel.
It was a nice throw, but our official says first baseman came off the bag. Did she catch at least a corner of the base before she slid off? And it looks like the umpires have gotten together to reverse the call. They say she did have enough of the plate. So how about Aaron King? Yeah, they're going to pull this out. Aaron King and the DMV defense getting it done. We'll step aside here before the bottom of the second on the Ocho Day.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Turf Wars Kickball, powered by Manscaped as part of ESPN 8, the Ocho Day, presented by Sonic. Hopefully all of you have been keeping up to date on your obscure sports quarterly reading. So the Ocho Day continues here at Manchester Meadows in Rock Hill, South Carolina, where we've got the third annual Turf Wars Kickball Showdown here on display. We've got two teams left standing in this tournament. Dwayne, it is the Dream Team from the DMV. They lead this club out of Florida 3-0 at the DMV. Listen, they are, you know, making their presence felt here in the early innings. They've got another base run.
Absolutely. I don't know if you saw that, but that was like a little sneaky kick. It was a delayed bunt. He made the backers feel as though he wasn't going to kick it, and then at the last second, he stuck his leg out and went right where it was supposed to be.
So, like, right there by the catcher, Blizzard, I mean, you've got to be so quick to pounce on it to retire the speedy runners.
Absolutely. And he, as you see on that play, he made a great play to get the lead runner out of second. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, it's coming back. They called it a double kick. So what's going on with this, with the butter, they have to put it out a little bit further. Now, you need a shot like that, they're going to get him out.
Double kick, pretty much self-explanatory. That just brings the kicker back to the plate.
And it's a foul. Absolutely.
All right, so again, leadoff base runner on for the Dream Team.
And the DMV Dream Team, they just keep coming at you with speed, speed, and more speed. The more you get down in that lineup, you think that you got him.
That would have been a long throw. Runner take it off. They peg him at third base. Now, all the while, the kicker reaches second. So he's still got a runner in scoring position. That's a gutsy base running move.
Oh, man, that was a heads-up play by my guy, Joshua Stowe. I told you he's a baller. Look out for him on defense. But he basically baited the lead runner to have him thinking that he was going to throw it the first, and he just tucked the ball, and he couldn't see it going around.
That's a bluff to throw. And then if you're the base runner there, you just got to commit to it and hope for some sort of chaos. All right, this is Tika Hartridge.
And she's a two-time ESPN player as well. She was on here the first year.
I mean, GP, this has been the main event here at Manchester Meadows kind of year after year. It always brings a crowd. It's competitive. It's fast-paced. We've alluded to the athleticism.
And I think the difference in this year, what we did was instead of the first 2 years, we selected different players that we felt as though that could put on a good show. This time we did it in its more natural, organic sense. We picked the captains, and the captains built the teams the way they wanted to. So therefore, it looks a little bit more organic.
And again, you had to play your way to this championship game. So a quick half inning for FOE. They really needed that. They had the great defensive play from Stowe, who picked the runner over at third base. Look, it's a fun watch. You and I have been doing this together for many years. And we've seen Turf Wars grow in a lot of ways. I mean, from your perspective here, how has just that kickball community continued to grow the last few years?
I just think a little bit more spotlight. Right? Yeah. As you see, this year, each year it gets bigger and bigger. This year we've added the home run ball. You know, just sticking to the grind and just doing what we do. And, you know, we know that it's a great game to watch. And we know that as soon as people get to see it on TV, they're going to fall in love with it.
More kickball. Yeah, more kickball on our airwaves. Hey, Bill Simmons said on a podcast once recently he would love to watch kickball on TV randomly. So, Bill, if you're watching, one swing, one out here. That was a good go at it. The leadoff kicker there for FOE, but there is one out. Again, we're still waiting for maybe the first big blast to the outfield. We haven't seen one just yet. Again, we're just getting started here.
And you see the strategy with this one, because this it's a lot of speed up the kick, and it's a great bunter.
Oh, that's a great play by the catcher.
That's a great play by catcher. Left a little bit too short.
So Sitko.
And Lillard, he's another great kicker as well. There's no button in his game. As you see what the outfield did, they know exactly what he's capable of.
No. So we've got Kellen Miller up to kick here. Yeah, there was a couple defensive substitutions. We added an outfielder. So it's a pretty clear illustration as to what he's bringing to the table. This one's got some carry underneath it. Confusion of the outfield. And so Miller will be aboard here for Florida's FOE.
FOE. They got a base runner. As you see, some miscommunication in the outfield. You got to call for the ball. If you don't, that's what happens.
And that's trickier than you think. Again, that ball, it can bounce. There is some, you know, some spring and some bounce to it. You really got to secure it when it's up in the air coming at you as an outfielder. Yeah, this is a great view right here. We've got our home run fence that was instituted earlier this summer. Just adds another dynamic to the game.
And as you see, with this being a big kicker, how the pitcher changed up his pitch. He's pitching a little bit more bouncier to try to throw off the timing of the kicker.
Big rip, and that one looked like it was foul anyway. I mean, I would assume with that greater chance that your kicker will just basically pop it straight up into the air.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. Especially if they can't catch the timing of it.
Well, Aaron King has so far baffled some of these FOE kickers. He's done a fine job here. Yeah, again, another pitch that had some good bounce to it. And again, it can't be too high of a bounce.
Exactly.
Or else that'll be an illegal pitch.
It'll be called a ball. Absolutely.
Well, so that was another foul kick in the at-bat. So that results in an out. Three scoreless innings for King. His team's up 3-0. So back with Dwayne Lucas, Kevin Fitzgerald with you. All right, so GP, what do we got coming up here? Turf Wars events coming up later this year. Where are you guys headed?
We're headed to Well, we have something going this weekend at Ortho Carolina.
Yep.
Ortho Carolina. And then Salt Lake in September 14th and 15th. And then we're going to Mesa, Arizona in November. November 15th through the 17th.
Taking the show on the road. This Turf Wars Kickball Association, you have had a hand in this, of course, for so many years. Our founder, Arion Herbert, you guys do a wonderful job of just continuing to grow the game, promote the game. It is a whole lot of fun. That is one thing we keep, you hear all the time from players all up and down the East Coast. It's a great competitive place to keep playing the game. 3-0 lead here for the Dream Team.
And as you see, they made a pitch and change.
Runner out at first.
Speed, but it was a better defensive play. Good play by the inside charger. And now we got a kick. We got Bree Connor up the kick. So another great bunter. It has great speed as well. And as you see with that one, she tried to do the delayed bunt. She tried to throw the back catcher off, have them think that she wasn't going to kick the ball. And at the last second, she stuck her foot out there and tried to bunt it down three, but it ended up going foul.
Dream Team trying to build on its lead here, but a couple of quick outs.
And now they're back at the top.
So I just got to make sure, though, that for the two down. Turf Wars event in Salt Lake City, we've got to have the home run hitter here, Kenny Meyer, right? And Legatron. Talk about kicking in the altitude, my friend. That, you guys will never, kickball will never return.
The ball will never come back. So we're back at the top. We got Dave up the kick. Oh, it's a kick. And he's going to. And he got out going a second. Well, that was a strategy. They didn't want to burn the top, so if he ended up getting in play, they was going to have him keep running unless he got safe to second. But on the way going to second, he got out. So,
all right, so, yeah, put 1-2-3 innings. Dream Team still up 3-0. Last pick, Manscaped. The city of Rocky
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Ocho Day. Listen, we're crowning a kickball champ here. We're going to hand out a gold medal. Yeah, who needs the Olympics? Listen, this is what you've got. So we've got store for you the rest of the day. We've got Major League Table Tennis that's coming up next. Cornhole later. We have the Pro Breakdancing Tour. I don't even know what Slippery Stairs is, but I'm excited about it. That's later today at 7. So, look, it is the world of seldom seen sports. We start inning number 4 in our kickball showdown. This is the Turf Wars Battle of the States. You got two states left standing here. It's a 3-0 lead for the Dream Team, representing the DMV. A lot of these players you're familiar with. And, I mean, listen, what can you say about Aaron King in the circle today? I mean, he's been terrific.
I told you, dynamite pitcher.
Now, he's someone you've coached?
I haven't coached him, but he's been playing with us ever since he was about like 8 or 9 as well.
Yep. He has been terrific. That's
a spin throw.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that was a great throw. Great defensive play. He did a little flex on him a little bit. Sometimes when you make a great play, you got to flex on him a little bit.
I would say every time you have to. This is like his third great play from behind the plate. That is not easy.
At all. But he makes it look easy.
Sometimes on the miss kick, there's some spin, right? On
a lot
that kickball.
So, yeah, so you gotta gather it.
Not a simple play by any means. And so I think King is having such a fine day. look out, look alive.
Keep your head on the swivel.
King is having such a good day. The outfielders haven't even really had a chance. This is, oh my God. Remember there was that old saying, dodge, duck, dip, dive? I think dodgeball is concluded right down the road from where we are. However, oh God, is he going to get pegged again? My goodness.
Again.
Have mercy on our kicker here.
Again, the strategy was they didn't want to burn the top, so put it in play, try to get the second. If not, start at the top of the lineup going to the next inning.
So he's been pegged more times than he has reached safely, which is a painful truth. However, it's another pretty clean inning here for DMV Dream Team. And again, that's a base hit there, but he's trying to stretch it. The defense here for Dream Team has been top notch.
Oh, they're locked in. They're locked in. No, my favorite scene from the movie Dodgeball is, you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
Well, not in this case for who's that again?
Josh.
For FOE? Yeah, Josh Stowe. It's been a painful top half of the fourth inning. It's been a painful start to this one. So, listen, if you're FOE, now you start to look at the clock here. We're going to play until the top of the hour. And the FOE squad out of Florida, they have got to turn this lineup quick and get back to the plate in the top half of the fifth inning. They're down 3-0. It was a 3 spot for the DMV Dream Team in the opening inning. That's the difference thus far.
Yeah, and I seem like when they jumped out and got that 3-0 lead, now they're just coasting and playing good defense.
They changed pitchers, as you mentioned before. So Miller is now in the circle. That's a leadoff base runner for DMV Dream Team. So Deontay Lindsey, he scored one of those runs.
Speed
back in the opening inning,
but he also had great ball placement on that bunt. So as you've seen, it wasn't even a no throw from the defense.
He can fly. Blizzo trying to retire here at second base. That's
he
a fortuitous out.
And that's a great athletic play as well too. As soon as he gets it in his hand, he lets it out, and it's on a rope straight to second base, and that's an out. You gotta get the ball out the hands outside the hands of the back catcher.
And that's really cut. We see off of the two-hand throw. You just try to get a little more control on it, right?
A little bit more control, yeah. And got our guy Kenny Miners back up to hit.
All right, so now the outfield has been put on notice here.
On notice.
Look out. Because Miner, yeah, he blasted a homer here. What was it, a couple years ago?
No, it was last year.
Last season, that's
last
where it was.
Year, yeah. Let's see if we can get this home run ball, though.
Whole lot of anticipation here. So that was a lot of bounce there. And Miller, though, able to have just enough height on the bounce there for it to be a strike.
Yep. Just trying to throw his timing off just a little bit.
There's a big kick. So that's a base hit. We're going to try to get the left at second. She's safe.
She slides in the second. She's got a run. Says that too.
So Kaya King is in second. Miners says, are you not entertained? Finally, there you go. I'll give you guys something here.
I'm going to find a place on the defense. I just need you to get to second base. And what they did a sub runner. And they're able to do that because he's married to him in the kicking lineup. So.
Yep. So it looks like Matt Henderson.
Yeah, that was the one that was playing back at you.
Yep.
Lots of speed.
So he is now going to pinch run there. And look, Dream Team is not done building upon this lead.
Just putting pressure.
So now at the plate, it's Aaron King again. He drove in a run in that first inning. King, sensational. 4 scoreless innings on the mound for DMV Dream Team. Well, there's a whole lot of bounce there, and you just saw the signal, yeah, from our home plate umpire. You can't bounce it too high, or else that will be ruled
a ball.
Yeah. King sizing it up right here. Here's something he can put into play, but instead he bounces it foul. So look alive down that first base line.
And as you see with his pitch, he's coming with a lot of cutter too. So if you don't catch it clean with your foot, it's going to spin right off and pop up in the air.
Yeah, there's something hit hard. And Stowe taps third for that second out. So FOE, they have got to retire Jennings here, who also had a base hit in the opening inning. They've got to get this to the fifth inning, only down 3 runs, running out of time. There's a rip there.
Oh, he's coming home.
Yeah, you can bet we're going to get the green light here for a base runner, and now it's 4-0. There's no bunting and no stop sign at third. Give him the green light.
Already knew when he was landing. With his speed, he's definitely just going all the way home.
This one's bounced to the left side of the diamond there, so the inning does come to a close, but Dream Team has now stretched its advantage to 4-0, and they are in prime position right here to maybe take home the crown. Listen, you mentioned before that you're going to be on the call tomorrow when this tournament here, right in the Charlotte-Pineville area continues. And there's always some cold, hard cash on the line for these tournaments. What do we got grand prize, by the way, this weekend?
Overall, over the weekend, we're going to be giving out over $8,000.
Oh, come on.
Oh, yeah.
8K is going to be awarded here.
And it seems as though that they're back at the top of the lineup. So if they're gonna try to knock some runs in or get some runs in or try to catch up, this is the best time to do it.
Well, and so Dwayne, here we go. We just got word here. We're getting close to our time limit. So the fifth inning is going to be the final inning. FOE has got to rally here, down 4 runs, and that's they have been totally overwhelmed here by King today on the mound for DMV. They need some base runners. Throw and on target. Jennings with a bullet to first. Take a look at this play.
Oh, they call it encroachment. So the kicker has another opportunity to put it in play.
Wow, so that nullifies this great field and throw. Wow, they got it by just a fraction, too.
Absolutely. It was just that last hop over the line before the ball was kicked. It was called that, caused that encroachment call.
And again, that's when the fielder jumps.
That diagonal line.
They jump over that hashed line that's right across the center of the field. All right, so FOE still with life. Still nobody out in this top half of the fifth. They got a rally here. Into play, Jennings.
That's the same.
Can't make the play this time.
Safe call. Ball safe. And here we go. They're at the top of the lineup. Speed, speed, and more speed.
Thad White. There's Lizzo. They've got the leadoff men on, so that was Kemp, who just reached safely for FOE. They need base runners, they need runs.
One home run is not going to do it, so they got to get people on base.
You know, and Aaron King here, he's a savvy kickballer. He knows he can take his time here.
He can.
With the clock winding down. He's got the wherewithal here to recognize he doesn't need to throw some of the top hitters a strike. We'll make him work for something.
He had four innings to get it done.
Oh, that's great. Lizzo puts it into play. Jennings, the dive throw. They retire the man at first. Just another brilliant defensive jam by the Dream Team here.
That was a great defensive play. Great chest pass.
Going for the gold medal here in this tournament.
Wow.
Another fine athletic play. This is the athleticism we have talked all about here.
Absolutely. And now we got Courtney Lucas up the kick. She's another great runner.
You got Kemp over at second base. With FOE down four runs, they've got a rally here with
just one out. Yeah, great ball.
Yeah, so she's going to reach. So runners at the corners.
She got runners at the corners. So we're looking like we got the kickers up. So if nothing else, they're definitely getting. They should be getting a run scored in. One out.
There's Glenn Van Winkle.
That's a great name.
It's a great fantastic name.
And watch the difference in the pitch. He knows he's kicking out, so he's going to throw a little bit slower, a little bit more bouncier to try to throw his timing off on his kick.
Oh, Van Winkle rips it. Catch is nearly made. FOE scores a run. We got something here.
We got life. We got life. We got another scary kick up the kick.
It is a 4-1 ball game. And hold on a second here. I mean, Legatron coming up. And he represents the tying run here.
He does.
Look alive. Legatron, he does not mess around. He just puts something into play here. Catch made.
But not far enough. Yep. Not far enough for the runners to advance.
And so FOE down to its final out.
There's two outs.
Yep, down to their final out here.
Gotta make something
and
happen.
What could very well, yeah, this could very well be our decisive fifth inning. 4-1 game, Dream Team ahead. They're trying to close it out here. I mean, Aaron King, by the way. This is pretty much the MVP, you think?
Absolutely.
He drove in a run as well, too.
He did. And that should be it.
That's it. They get the out in third. DMV Dream Team. Let the coronation begin here. They win the Battle of the States. Here on ESPN 8, the Ocho Day, the Dream Team gets to celebrate a 4-1 win in Rock Hill.
They did it in grand fashion, too. They did it in grand fashion.
And this was an obvious one. Yeah, they're celebrating with AK Aaron King. He is our Manscaped MVP for this DMV Dream Team. This was an obvious selection. Yeah, he drove in a run in that 3-run first inning. He also pitched nearly five scoreless. He went four scoreless, then that 1 run scored there in that fifth inning. But DMV Dream Team comes away with the title here. We're back to break it all down, and we come back on the other side here in Rock Hill. Listen, when you win your DMV Dream Team, you step into the Sonic spotlight. The winning team, they got the slush celebration afterward. Ocean slush, courtesy of Sonic, I think is just a beautiful touch to close out our kickball showcase. And then how about this? Is this a little surprise here from Arion Herbert? The
Stepping it up with the ring.
The founder. Championship rings here for the team representing the DMV Dream Team with a 4-1 victory. Aaron King, the MVP. This was a fun show today once again, GP.
I wish we could do it more than just once a year, my friend, but this is what we got.
Well, enjoyed working with you. As always, always a pleasure.
Always.
So for Dwayne Lucas and our entire great crew, Kevin Fitzgerald saying so long. The Ocho Day continues next.